story of robots. Chapter 3. Robot race. Racers. If only. Squeaky, the cleaning robot, hated his job. He was out in all weather sweeping streets. What he really wanted was to win the Boltsville Road Race. The winning robot would get a new memory chip and a hat wheel polish. But Squeaky didn't dare enter. He was so rusty and clanky, he wasn't sure he could even finish the race. He was feeling sorry for himself when a noisy robot zoomed past. "Out of the way, Rose Bucket!" "Hey!" Tank Top was the biggest, meanest robot in town. Everyone was curtain, he would win tomorrow's big race. Tank Top wasn't taking any chances. He had a plan to make sure none of the other racers even started. That night, at the Boltsville robots recharged themselves, Tank Top visited each of his rival in secret. He gave Tina Turbo a puncher, Sir Caliber Seed's memory chip, undid Android's battery pack, and rest Betty's birth in alarm clock, she slipped right through the race. Maybe he was surprised, maybe she would indeed, or did she notice? The next morning, Tanta was the only robot at the starting line. It looked as if his plan had worked. The jock was puzzled. "It seems you're the only contestant. I take my prize now. There must be someone else winning to race," cried the jerk disputedly. Tanto was making him look stupid. Just then, a tiny voice peeped up. "I will." Everyone in the crowd turned. "It's that Squeaky," said someone in amazement. "You, what chance have you got?" "I'd still like to try." Squeaky's joints were feeling especially stiff today, but he couldn't miss this chance. "Very well," said the jerk. "With a side of Ralph, robot on your marks." Tantov hadn't bothered to charge up his battery that morning, but he was confident he could still beat Squeaky. Get set, bang! Zoom, with a clock. The robots set off on their lap of the town. Tanko raced off with a roar. Squeaky clacked off in a hot pot shirt. As soon as he was out of sight, the crowd. Tato opened a flat in his back. "Ha ha, these nails will slow down that robot wilk." But by the time Squeaky spotted the spiky trap, it was too late. Luckily, Squeaky was so old that his wheels were made of solder rubber. They didn't burst, and he was still in the race. "Ouch! I'll show you that chat," thought Squeaky. He put on a burst of speed. Soon he'd caught up with Tanko. Let's see you get out of this, boomed Tanko as he opened another compartment. Oh, yo! Squeaky shut his eyes and hoped for the best as he slithered and slid all over the road. Whoa! Crack! Squeaky was left first and dented, but at least he was still in one piece. He tried to get up and found he couldn't move. His joints were too stiff. Now I've lost for sure. As he sat there, Squeaky realized what he needed was all around him. Unreining his hopes, he guzzled up every last drop of oil. Slop? That feels good. Maybe rubber-like oil. Soon, Squeaky was back on his rebel's tail. Tanko was running out of power fast. But Tanko still had one trick up his sleeve. His telescope arms. He reached out to Squeaky's front wheel and undid in scroll. Spark flew through the air as Squeaky's wheel bounced past Tank Top. In seconds, Squeaky had ground to a halt. As the crowd came back into view, Tank Top used the last of his power to roll across the finishing line. Ha ha, I've won! Ha ha ha. Tank Top was already boasting to the crowd as poor old Squeaky was carried across the line.
Congratulations,
cried the jock as he shook Squeaky by the hands. Well, I suppose I almost won, Squeaky sniffed sadly. Not almost, said the jock. You did win, look! He showed Squeaky and Tanktop the photograph taken at the finishing line. Your wheels crossed the line a second before Tanktop. That makes you the winner. Squeaky clucked with delight. The crowd cheers and Tanktop blew a fuse. The end.